we gather once again to say our goodbyes to Emil. And we do that when we pray each day. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Yes. To all of us who have gathered here as sisters and brothers, we believe that all ties of friendship and affection which knit us as one throughout our lives does not unravel with death, and confident that God always remembers the good we have done and forgives our sins, let us ask God to gather all of us together to remember once again Emil. And so we pray. In heaven in a very different way, that he's one with the Lord and he still can help all of us as we continue our journey. Because where we get little pieces of light and little pieces of peace, that Emil experiences the total peace of Christ, the total light of Christ, the day that he died in 1943. And that's why we can celebrate his life. And lastly, we believe that as Christian people, faith is a great gift that God has given to all of us. It's a gift that's given so freely to help us on our journey. Because we know the uncertainties and the confusions that exist in life. And I'm sure Emil had a deep sense of faith in his love for his country, love for God, and love for his church, that he decided to go and become a Marine. And again, he did it faithfully and he did it lovingly because his faith did that. And therefore, our faith does the same thing in the midst of uncertainties. How do we give thanks to a man who died in 1943? That I think the greatest way is that takes something of his life, that the gift for Victor and for Dominic and his nieces and all the other family members and cousins and friends we hear, that again, he had an impact on life, even though it was a very, very short time. And we have to remember too, that life is a very, very fragile gift. And sometimes we need not to put off to tomorrow what needs to be done today. And I truly believe that families, parents need to tell their children that they love them and vice versa. We know that. But sometimes we need to express it. Sometimes when there's hurt, sometimes it needs to be healed. You can imagine Dominic and Victor and all the whole Ragucci family, that the hurt that their parents must have felt after losing two people. But yet what helped them was faith and family.
Thank you. Brother Emil. Let us pray to the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live, even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
So eternal rest granted to you, O Lord, let perpetual light shine upon you. May you rest in peace. Amen.
Amen.
And may your soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.